Welcome back for round two coverage presented by Sky Hyzer Productions. Evansville Open presented by Westside Disc Golf. Here's your lead card. And then here are your leaders. You got a six-way tie. People chasing Paul at 10 under. He's got a three-stroke lead there. We're going to be going to Mesker. It's going to be original hole 8. We're going to be hole 1 for today, 331 feet. We're going to go down and to the right. If you can make it over this hill, it makes things a lot easier. But traditionally, you got a really tricky upshot.
Baby, baby.
Well, slow down.
Slow down.
Slow down.
Oh, look at that shirt.
Yeah, that's a flex. Yeah, Paul's wearing his Dutch shirt. So forehand is a popular play here. There's an early gap, and then there's a late gap. You see a lot of overstable mid-ranges.
I forgot. I thought there was one oddball.
No, there was like six or seven.
Oh, there's Dutch.
Yeah.
Looks like he gave Paul his hand down.
Dutch taking that early gap. You play it in the winter, it looks like it's a lot more open. It's not, it just looks that way. But when the green's up, it's really, it seems like it's really difficult to get anywhere near that basket. And if you push too far, there's a creek down there. There's Derek. Okay. So Dutch off the early gap.
Oh, yes.
Dutch going turbo. That's a Dutch move. He's past it. Yeah, so there's DG. He's down in the creek bed. Got a forehand. Yeah, that's a great shot.
That's good.
Yeah, good recovery. Nathaniel pitching up. Another great shot. Paul just over the rise there.
Dutch in the ditch again.
Yep. There was a snake down there that was pointed out. It's off to the left there, about 4 feet. So that's the wildlife moment.
There he is.
Yeah, that was a good putt.
Slippery snake.
Nathaniel here. Got a good look at par.
Yeah. Tell you what it is, the fucking nope rope.
The weather's already coming in at this point. You can see everybody's kind of playing quick.
That's exactly what
I was saying. I just feel like it's moving fast.
Yeah.
Hole two, got a par three, 221 feet. Just a wide hyzer, missed the hanging tree, let it scoot up there. Easy birdie.
And actually, it's just me, just one camera at this point. Paul here, giving it a run for sure. Just kind of got to go out over the bridge and don't get sawed off on the left-hand side. And take something you trust to fade back. Dutch pushing through there.
The Nathaniel Romans.
Yes.
He was once my doubles, random doubles partner.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. And we won. So I got the higher back tag.
Yeah, I tried to pick a spot on this hole where you could see him throw, but also see the result. It was spot that I knew they weren't going to be throwing directly at my head. It's another one that's a nice little walk here across the bridge.
Outside.
This park was built during the Great Depression, so these were WPA projects to put these bridges in. A lot of history in this park.
Not familiar with
DG
that.
Knocking nice it down. Point. Knocking down the birdie. always fun having DG on the card. Somebody's left their putter. Dutch knocking down the two.
Is that a baby stroller? Oh, no, it's not.
No, it's a ball golf push cart that's been converted, because that's not the Rovin. It's got two wheels on the front.
Boy's crafty.
And you really can't see it with the exposure here, but that sky is dark. And it is almost right on top of us at this point. I really wish that exposure would show it. It's
hole 3, 436 feet. This is downhill, usually into a headwind. The normal play is to hang it out over the road and let it come back. Let it scoot up there and hopefully get your bird.
The road and right of the road is out of bounds. We didn't really get any damage on the course. There were really good storms that came through. A couple of branches came down, a couple of limbs, but not anything like what we expected. Paul taking the inside gap. Not bad. Yeah, we were. I think we made it all the way up to the tee pad before the horns went off, or the weather siren went off.
That's probably convenient.
So we only made it to two holes before we got to stop.
Now you gotta deal with wet pads.
Yeah.
That always makes things awkward for me. I don't trust my foot in order.
Whoops.
Nathaniel, yeah, you slipped there.
Oh, cool. Good start.
Good commentary.
DG. Taking that wide gap.
All I wanted.
Not getting any ground play this afternoon. Ball that rain.
I get to stay at work on this day. I get to look out the big pane windows. Be happy I couldn't make it today.
So Nathaniel off of his Marco B. It's pretty much right there at the short tee pad. High route. Yep, he's in the trees there.
Yeah,
recovered. DG giving it a run. Snuggling up there close. Paul taking the tower out. Spike it in. Give it a chance. Dutch was a pretty good look here. Just off the top end.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah. Great save, man.
Yeah. clean up his par. Yep. Yeah, so the point here was to make sure that everybody played the same holes. So we weren't sure what the weather was going to do. And, well, there we go. There's the putt under the leg. Style points.
Hole four is a tricky little uphill shot. You just need to stay out of the stuff on the right. Don't hit that tree to the left. Let it scoot up there. Pretty straightforward. Beautiful hole.
Hole four, hole two on the course, 247 feet. Straight. Got a guardian tree there, short left. If you go long, you can get in trouble in the woods behind. Got a camera. There you go. A little bit past on the left side. That hill's a little treacherous after that much rain.
Need some four-wheel Crocs.
In here, it's not raining, but we're getting the rain coming down off the trees. DG giving it a run.
Thank you.
This one's pretty straightforward, especially for these guys. Smooth. Looks like maybe dropped just on the top of it.
You know I'll be in your MP40 next year.
Everybody's looking forward to playing that hybrid layout in this event, so that was a tough call, but TD got a hold of the state coordinator and they talked about it and decided that this was the thing to do. With a birdie there, gets it to 1200. Touch with his birdie. I have a star frame here. Oh, style points? Yep. More style points.
Style points.
Hole three, a lot downhill with a little uphill at the end. Got to miss that tree, and then you're hoping not to go down that hill.
Some sneaky lines on this one. Different routes to get there, forehand routes, backhand routes.
Turn.
Ball hitting that tree on the left. Kick to the right. The road and left of the road is out of bounds on this hole. And the road long is out of bounds.
Get up there.
Oh. Yeah, Dutch doing a little gardening there.
Very
of course, dude. It's always appreciated.
It's not uncommon to see drives pushed down all the way to the next tee pad. It's a fast green. You get a skip on top there, which is nothing up there to stop it.
Come on.
Just close to pin high. in the woods back there.
There's usually some sort of alleyway right at the basket.
Yeah. Daniel gets a kick down the left. He's still in bounds, though. Yep.
The footing is crappy.
Yeah, a little.
But it's better than OB, I guess.
Just kind of stretch out and, yeah, get that pan out, stall out. Paul just pitching up. Gave a run. I'm trying to remember.
He
hit that. Yeah, he hit that branch and brought that branch down. That's. Mm-hmm. I'm surprised that he went over the right side of the fairway.
Did it?
This is Derek Green doing Derek Green things out of the woods. Daniel knocking down his bird.
He's always high energy.
Oh, for sure. Dutch is carrying everything in his hands.
Brought up right. One trip to the car with the groceries. Hole 6 uphill. 286 feet. Missed squash. Let it Hyzer in. Easy two.
No matter how many times I shoot with a laser, this thing plays like 350.
Well, that's, yeah.
It says 286 on the sign and 286 on the laser.
I was the one that ran out and shot all these with the laser.
It feels so much longer than that.
I can't tell you how many times I had to shoot it and then shoot it and then shoot it and make sure I've hit it. I'm like, I guess that's got to be right.
DG hit that. That's that branch there, yeah.
Leave Sasquatch alone. He's a nice fish. He's a nice guy. Yeah,
branch.
You gotta get some bigger googly eyes for him.
Except he hit that branch and it looked like he kicked right, but he got some ground play. He's actually down on the left.
Dutch Omen.
Right. Place the gap.
Shot ball.
That full body control on his disc. Is Dutch Napier?
Sneaky. Yeah. It's not a bad result. He's up there. To flip up, just pot branch. DG forehand.
Got out of there.
Yeah.
He's jumping up and down for joy.
Again, it's not, you know, it's not raining. Just wind's bringing it down out of the trees.
Oh,
that's a good run.
Yeah.
Good run, good result. Didn't roll away. Seems like this tree that's right in front of him is kind of the spot. If you can get there off the tee, see a lot of birdie putts from just in front of that tree. But otherwise,
oh.
Good job. Right. All here for his two. Got it. Okay, so DG gets out of there with a bogey. Nathaniel comes up with par.
Hole five downhill, just keep it not over that road. Finish left, control your skip.
Just trying to push something past that tree in the middle. Get it to fade at the end.
Double mando's in play? Yeah.
Yep. That got all the way down there. That's a good line there, but all that rain and the grass is it. Not too high, but it just grabbed it. He didn't get any skip at all. Clean through. Back a little short. Branch there up high.
No good.
No good.
How good?
Yeah.
No good.
So he's looking at forehand or backhand, trying to match up the angle. So he's got an easier, that was, I think that was all about matching up the angle. Make sure he didn't get a bad roll away.
Nope.
Leave it out of the hand. Dutch is looking at how much he wants to run this.
All of it. He's doing all of it. Kind of has to, doesn't he? He's not good.
He's scared of
it. He's scared. I think he wanted to.
Oh, yeah.
Tester coming back for Nathaniel. That's not a tester for him.
All day, good. Baby.
All day long.
He is ecstatic.
Yeah. Been a long day. Yeah, Paul got all the way down there off it. Yeah. Wish we had a catch cam down there. I'd like to see how that came in on the basket.
Thanks a lot, Steven.
Sitting up there in the clubhouse, shelter house doing important things like, you know, watching the weather and lightning strikes.
Acting like a TV.
Yeah. Paul, hitting up far. Style points for far.
Hole 8, 383 feet uphill. Roller's your best chance if you're looking for the two. Other than that, throw it up there. Upshot, putt, take your three. Next hole.
Oh, it's looking at roller.
I hear that is the way to get up there.
Yeah, that's something else I keep trying to remember. I need to try next time I'm out there.
Oh, I don't think it matters. Listen at the short key, I'm just not making it there.
This is a fun one to play. I like playing this one from back here. I'll just get a good rip. Turn over a little bit, just get it through the gap, get it, like you said, just get forward of that short tee pin. Nathaniel also trying to force over a roller. Yeah.
It's so hard to get him past that.
Yeah, you can see it just curl around there. Through the gap and have a long upshot.
I mean, he'd prefer would run up there and then just run down just so he can get both shots.
Okay, yeah, he's messing with me. Talking about making me run back and forth with the camera. Good up.
That's about all I tried to do.
Mm-hmm.
Get up there and then throw it at it, see what happens.
Give yourself an easy par putt.
Oh, for infinite.
Dudge going a little bit past.
You alright?
Not too bad about
it. Wide open. Give him a chance. Just past it. Oh, a little bit closer. Got some branches there. That kind of makes it hard, but.
Oh,
Dutch off off the basket there. Using chains for back roller.
Fucking assaulted me.
Everybody cleaning up the threes.
Hole 9, straightforward, right in front of you. Traditionally, the pumpkin hole for the PSO. We'll see you there.
236 feet. Uphill all the way, low ceiling. Definitely plays longer than that. And since we're playing a shortened round, this is our last hole.
He didn't hit the pumpkin.
Nope.
Simming in a shot.
Yeah, so coming into this hole, Paul's got a 3-shot lead on the card. Yep.
You like my play that much?
PG at 9 under, Daniel at 8 under. stayed out of the junk there. That's the risk on this hole if you don't push it up there enough, get the right line on it. A really tough putt for those trees there, a little short left. Derek there, yeah, getting really good ground play.
Slide, yeah.
Yeah.
You started off last slide. That's what y'all were when practicing, pumpkin, right? The slide shot up there?
Yeah. You got a pumpkin and a green.
There's no reason
there
to run it.
It's like the one time you can ace and get mad. Oh, no.
Just off the top band.
Shoot, buddy. How'd you wait till the last hole to do that?
DG's out here. The dust is
going to
go.
He's going to put the groceries down. This one.
Set everything down. I'll make this last one.
This one's crucial. Oh, yeah. I guess it kind of is, isn't it?
Down. Dust gets to 11 under. DG trying to get to double digits.
Oh.
Looked like he was leaning out a lot. Might have thrown him off his form a little bit. Ball here to close it out with a birdie. Yep.
Yeah, Paul.
Paul gets to 14 under. Nathaniel, DG, closing out the pars.
And that'll wrap things up here for the Evansville Open. Paul takes another one home. He's been here before, followed by Dutch, Zach, Derek, Sam, Steven. Want to give a shout out to Westside Discs for the sponsorship. We got Ace Eagle Disc Golf Club members for making that course beautiful. Bustlers, they're always in our mix and helping out and adding stuff in there. Kevolution, Sunday Crew. From all of us, we'd like to say thank you. We'll see you next time.